Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. So these are for the early model Volkswagens, what are called the A1, A2, and A3 platforms. This is the relay shaft that sits vertically in the engine bay. So this sits in a bracket that's bolted to the transaxle. And then it's got this lever on the bottom here called the relay lever. And the way this works is there's a rod that comes up from your shifter next to the driver's seat. And that rod pushes back and forth on this ball. And when that pushes, it makes this thing go side to side. And that actuates a matching lever that's called the selector lever on the transaxle. This is one of the factory bushings, so there's actually two of these bushings. It'd be one at the bottom here where you can see those marks, and then one up here at the top. So there's normally two of these bushings that sit in that bracket. The problem is these bushings are made out of squishy polyurethane. Because it's squishy, they let this thing move all over the place, and over time this polyurethane gets hard and brittle as it loses the plasticizers, and this will actually wear down and start breaking. And at that point, your relay shaft wobbles all over, and you're not getting the motion that makes the shifter work. You're getting all sorts of wild gyrations. So one of the things we make is a replacement bushing. This one happens to be our Teflon model. We also make one in what's called UHMW polyethylene. So this is ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene, and this is oil impregnated. That's what gives it that gray color. And you can see I can't squeeze this, just barely squeeze that with all my force, where this one, it's just soft. So anyway, making a batch of these Teflon bushings, and I thought I'd show you how we make one of those. And then the other thing we're going to come out with pretty soon is we also have a 3D printed version of these bushings. But yeah, there's those, and let me show you how we make these Teflon ones. I'm making a batch of those today. What I have here is a blank of Teflon, and we clamp that up here in the jaws. So there's a lot of setup time with this cut. The cut itself doesn't take very long, but there's a lot of time setting this up, which I skipped over just for the interest of video. Let's make the cut, and then I'll show you what we do next. Run the cut right up to the jaws on the lathe, and then what I do is I brought in my drill bit, and I'm going to run the drill bit in without moving the part. And there we go. We got that drilled. And then what I do is clean up the outside and the inside edge. And there we have two of the steps done. Okay, and then this is the finishing machining step. We cut the excess material. We had to leave extra material on there to leave enough surface for the lathe jaws to grab without distorting the material. And then at the end we got to cut most of that off, so I run that through like this. There's a finished bushing. Okay, there we have one of our bushings machined. And then last step, I just drill a small hole there with a countersink, and then we run in a screw there. And then that basically makes the bushing function just like the original one. So instead of having a tab molded in there like the original bushing, we have the screw there that prevents the bushing from moving inside of the bracket. And like I say, our 3D printed ones, when we get those ready, we'll have the tab as part of the part. The bushing that the original bushing and our Teflon bushings are a little bit taller, but with the 3D printed bushings we're making the bushings even taller, because the taller the bushings are, the more control they have over the shaft. So you can see here, if you hold both of those and they cover more of the shaft, there's less likelihood that the shaft will wiggle like that. So this shaft should only turn on the vertical axis. It shouldn't move like that or like that, because that's wasted motion. And with the shift linkage on the Volkswagens, you only have a certain amount of travel at the shifter, and if any of that motion gets lost in this shaft wiggling around, you can't shift gears properly, and these Teflon bushings will stand up to the heat and the engine oil and all the dirt and grime under your vehicle. So these will take up to about 400 to 500 degrees Fahrenheit. Polyurethane is only good to about 200 Fahrenheit, and the polyethylene is good to a little bit higher temperature than the polyurethane. So this is our kind of economy upgrade. And then the Teflon is what we call our extreme duty bushing, because one of the problems is this bottom bushing is about that far away from your exhaust pipe. That bushing gets cooked, that bottom one. So anyway, that is our Teflon relay shaft bushing. That's our UHMW, ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene. And then this is our nylon 6 version. So we hope to have those available pretty soon. Yeah, so if you have any questions, post up in the comment section below. I'll put a few videos over here on the side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.